Hello, I'm Sin with the OSINT Dojo, and in this video, we're going to cover the steps needed to solve the Sakura Room on TryHackMe. The Sakura Room is the OSINT Dojo's first publicly released OSINT-related room on the TryHackMe platform. And although it's designed for beginning OSINT practitioners, it uses a wide variety of tools, techniques, and methods that not everyone may be familiar with. For this reason, we have created written and video walkthroughs to help point you in the right direction if you need help, or should you get stuck on a particular question or technique. I highly encourage that you attempt to solve these challenges on your own, and only consult these guides when you are truly stuck and have exhausted all other research avenues. Now, before moving on, I want to be very clear that these walkthroughs will not be providing the actual flag needed to answer these questions. Instead, we want to focus on teaching the actual methodology and tools that are needed to obtain the flags, while still requiring that you follow the steps and locate the actual flag yourself. We feel that this provides a better learning experience and reduces the temptation to simply copy and paste in the flag and move on to the next question. Now, with that out of the way, let's jump in and get started on task one. In task one, we're giving a brief overview about the room itself, including the fact that if you're participating in the OSINT Dojo's badge program and you've reached at least the student level, you can also apply for a special badge once you've solved this room. The objectives of task one is simply to ensure that you've read all of the background and instruction information before you get deeper into this room. So if we take a look here at question number one, it simply asks if we're ready to begin. And we can look up here at the instruction set, and we're given the actual flag that we need to type in. So if we'll just copy this and paste it in down here and click submit, that will help us solve the first question. Task 2 provides a short synopsis of a fictitious cyber attack which occurred on the OSINT Dojo. This task provides an image file that was obtained following the attack and asks you to analyze the file for any breadcrumbs that might assist in identifying the perpetrator. Let's right-click the link to the image file and open it up in a new tab so we can analyze it. Now, just taking a look at the visual characteristics of this image, the one thing that immediately stands out to me is the binary that we can see here in the background. We could type this character by character into a binary translator, but let's keep digging as there might be an easier solution to this. Looking up at the URL bar here, notice that the file extension is .svg, which is a scalable vector graphic. Now, sometimes these types of images can contain metadata embedded in the file when the image is generated. We can actually view this data in our web browser by simply right-clicking the image and then clicking Inspect. Hovering over, we can see the different elements here that make up this image, such as the different text objects. Let's copy the binary that we can see here and paste this into our binary translator. That way we don't have to do it character by character manually. As you can see, we get a response that a picture is worth a thousand words, but metadata is worth far more. Unfortunately, this doesn't provide us with the necessary flag we're looking for, but it does let us know that we are on the right track by looking into the file's metadata. So let's go back and let's keep digging. Up here at the top is additional information about this file, including what software created it, the height and width of the image, as well as the file name and the file path. If we look closely, we can see that there is actually a username included here in the file path. Just copy this username, and we're going to paste it into our answer box. Click submit, and we can move on to the next task. Task 3 starts off by pointing out that the attackers made the OPSEC mistake of using the username we identified in task 2 across their other social media profiles. We are asked to leverage this username and pivot to locate the rest of their digital footprint so that we can identify their personal email address as well as their real name. Now, we could mainly check a bunch of different common social media sites by plugging the username into their URL structure, but instead, let's use a username lookup tool called What's My Name. Now, this only returns one match for a GitHub profile, so let's click on it and navigate to the HTML URL to view the actual GitHub repository. Since we're looking for information about the fraudster's email, let's go with the PGP repo and open the only file that's in there. We can extract the attacker's email address by simply copying this public PGP key and saving it to a .asc file. Then we can use a tool such as Cleopatra, or just run the gpg import command from the Linux command line to obtain this email address. Simply copy, paste it into our answer box, and click submit. Now, to get the attacker's full name, we need to pivot to another platform. You'll remember that GitHub was the only platform that we got from the What's My Name tool. But sometimes, these types of tools don't get all of the results. So let's move over to Google here and run the username in a search. As you can see, there is an additional result for a LinkedIn profile using the same username. Clicking on the link, we can see our attacker's full name. We can simply copy this name, paste it into the answer box, and then click submit.